What's up? I'm Mark from Blink 182. Welcome to Launch. We're here recording our new album in this house.
We moved into a house that a family lived in, or still lives in.
This family wants their home back. That would suck if we have to pick up and leave here.
This is the story of how our album is recorded.
I don't want to record today.
That's some one take right there, people. What happened while we were recording it?
I mean, I've never been a father before. I'm still a kid.
Meeting and playing for the troops that are in the armed forces was the most enlightening and humbling experience I've ever had.
It's a long story.
It feels like this record is taking forever to record and write.
It's a story about friendship.
I'm gonna miss you, Travis.
I wish somebody fun would show up.
You guys come for some fun? About the creative process.
That's awesome. All right, we just hit on something big.
About the way that people treat each other when people stop being polite and start getting real, man.
We all had an idea of recording in a house a few years ago, but it never really worked out. I think everyone was scared to death. But this time, we just said that we're gonna do it, and we moved into a house that a family lived in, and now we're surrounded by all their photos. We feel guilty every time we run around naked and do weird things to our bodies.
We finished the last tour, and we haven't really done much with Blink since then.
We had a lot of time off to go do stuff that was creative. Everyone was having babies. I was gonna go off and just do the transplants. I think during that time, like, we were just writing songs, like, individually, me and Tom.
Over the past couple of years, I've had a lot happen to me personally, and so I started writing these darker, heavier types of songs, and that's what Boxcar Racer was. 'Cause I feel so mad.
Back, you know, as like our little group. It's like being reunited with a girlfriend.
Get ready for action.
I want this record to take what people think Blink 182 is and completely destroy that and rebuild it in something really different than it's ever been. I want people to put this record on and go, wait a second, that's Blink 182.
Ready for action.
We've never had the time to just sit around and be creative, and we're fortunate enough right now that we can take over this house and try different ideas and try different sounds, and we're demoing everything right now. We're still in the demo process of writing, and it's really allowed us to expand the way which we write songs.
Any record I do, I'm gonna treat it like it's my first record. And even as our band, like, I was like, let's just pretend this is our first record. That way we're not worried about anything, we're not limited, we're not like, people don't expect anything, but we're just doing whatever we feel like at the time.
So that was me flowing. I was speaking with my drums.
The hardest thing about recording a record, it's gotta be the very first day you walk in and you sit down and you pick up your guitar and you're all, I have an idea for a song. It sounds so shitty every time you pick it up. Because then when, you know, you haven't really done that for like a good year or 2 years or something, and you sit down, and what you're hearing in your head is different from what they might be hearing with their ears. So you have to somehow ask them to get inside your head.
I like it on the bass, I like it on there.
I should do stupid like in that song.
Like this word, like I'll just feedback and then do that break and then I'll come in with you.
I'm here the whole time, like I'm not going nowhere. I usually record my drums and I break out, but this time I'm hanging out through the whole recording process. I've never felt more comfortable recording stuff ever as we are in this house.
The most challenging part of recording is just to keep the energy up, because you're in a studio, and people think that recording is like this big party where everyone just rocks out, there's microphones, and all of a sudden there's an album, but it's really a lot of, you know, sitting in a chair, listening to playback, doing things over and over and over again until you get it right.
How's that?
I think it's cool.
Hello, 1, 2. Hey, test, 1, 2.
Silence. Silence don't mean a thing. Silence, silence don't mean a thing.
You know what recording is like?
Recording is like doing this
for 4 months in a row.
One more time of the in the wind.
So you're right. You're out of key.
Silence don't mean a thing.
Play it faster. Play it slower.
This sounds ugly. It's a horrible melody. Oh, really? What the am I singing? It sounds like the devil came in through my butt and came out my mouth.
Silence!
Yeah, you can choose a higher
problem. I'm not feeling any of the that I'm doing. It's nowhere as good as like the music. It sounds like a door.
Let's just go on a new song and come back to this. Something that we'll be driving in our car one day and it'll come to us or whatever, you know? I feel like my spirit's being broken over the camel's hump today. I want to start recording the actual record and stop demoing. It's been here 2 months and we haven't actually laid anything down on the tape. I want to start laying stuff down on the tape. I'm ready to start recording.
In about a week or so, our producer's gonna come on down to the studio. We'll start recording these songs for you and your mom to listen to.
Jerry's here, and our engineer's here, and we're getting ready to...
There's Jerry. There's Jerry Finn.
Jerry's kind of like a... It'd be like if you were putting something together when you were a child, and your dad or your mother's sitting over you going, okay, do this. They're kind of like telling you the steps if you get lost.
And then you stop. And wait for the one, and then you start over on the and again.
Working with Jerry is like having the fourth member of Blink-182.
Jerry Finn!
Mr. Finn, please come here.
He's a great producer in that he comes from a really strong musical background. He grew up playing in punk rock bands, and so he understands music and he understands how a song should be structured. Cameron, I record that.
Sounds cooler than the other thing.
Yeah, cooler than the other thing.
Yeah.
Seriously.
It's a little bit better.
Seriously. It's okay.
It's so good.
Exactly a clear vision of where we wanted to take our music. The songs are a lot more diverse and there's a lot more emotion in the songs.
Songs in the can so far, and I think they're great. So I mean, you know, two great songs. Now all we gotta do is record a bunch of and throw together the rest of the album. We're golden. Coming up next on Album Launch, the people that we are renting the house from, they want their house back. There's no way we're gonna move out of here. They're just gonna have to kick us out.
Time to go record the Blink record.
perfect world, we'll finish the record in 3 months, maybe 4 months. But this time we're building each song individually, you know, doing drums, guitar, bass, singing, adding more things, and then starting on the next song, and maybe going back to the first song later on and trying all this different stuff out. So who knows? It might take 5 years.
Play it.
1, 2, 3, 4, 1.
Now, Travis is about to leave on tour of the Transplants, so he works with us from noon to 6 every day. Then he goes to Transplants rehearsal.
See, me going on the Transplants tour is going to put things behind a little bit. Well, hopefully we'll be done with all our songwriting.
Yeah, it sucks. I mean, I'm leaving. There's nothing I can do about it, you know?
What'd you say? Going
on tour, there's nothing I can do.
What I plan on doing is like getting a bunch of drum beats, a bunch of, you know, parts, and then giving them like a big box of my creativity before I leave on that tour.
It's gonna be fun.
So sleepy. I'm very sleepy. My kid gets up at 4:30 in the morning. I'm here at the studio till midnight. So I have to catch up on my sleep while Travis does his drum stuff.
I think I laid down some winners. That was very creative.
I'm gonna miss you, Travis.
I miss you too.
Every day you should call and leave a message for us, and then we'll play it when we get here. I'll play it on speakerphone. What's up, you guys? It's Travis. I'm in Detroit tonight. So I miss you guys, and I hope you guys are making a kick-ass record, things like that. It would help me out. Recording is so slow. We worked for 10 hours yesterday, and all we did was try different guitar sounds, different guitar cabinets with different heads, different guitars with different strings, different this with different that, different microphone placements, different everything. We've been here for like 3 hours, and we haven't actually started recording guitars yet. It's a lot of work to get the guitar sounds right.
This guitar sounds awesome. 1, 2, 3, 4. 2, 2, 3, 4.
Yeah, the people that we are renting the house from, they want their house back. I don't think that we're going to be done in time for them to come back and take their house. There's no way we're going to move out of here. They're just going to have to kick us out. Today we pack up and move to the new studio.
We will be moving on to greener pastures. We will go to another studio. We will write awesome songs.
Tom's about to record a lick unlike any other lick that's ever been recorded. Show him how it's gonna go, Tom. For real, show him the real part that you're about to record.
This is my lick.
Show him the guitar part you're about to record.
Does not sound good ever since it broke and got written all over it.
Yeah. The thing's gonna hurt you.
This crack is just gonna keep getting bigger.
Did he tell you what's gonna happen when these days? It's gonna spring off and break your other hand.
No!
Yes.
It will. It'll be a big shocker if you're playing. No. 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 No! Would it really break my hand?
Yeah. Yes.
Alright, well, I guess I'll have to break this guitar. Let's go outside and break it.
You're gonna break this guitar, man. It's so cool.
Oh. Yo!
What's up, Slavis?
Captain.
How you doing, man?
Good. Nice to see you.
Good to see you.
When Travis took off, we had so much work to do. We had like 6 songs we were kind of working on at that period of time. When he came back, we still had 5.5 left to go, so it's like, didn't even matter.
We're taking photos for our record.
only thing that's ruining the photos is that.
You guys got a camera over there? You do have a camera right here. Hello.
Go.
He's a stressful dad, dude. A million people calling us for a million different things.
You.
We gotta play shows today. Not today, we gotta play shows coming soon. We haven't played in like a year.
Play a show in like 10 days or something. We'll probably be really good because we haven't played in a year.
We were asked to do some shows a long time ago. We said, hey, yeah, let's book those shows because it's going to be so far in the future. We'll be done with our record. It'd be no big deal. Well, what happened was is the record was taking way longer than we thought.
What's today, Tuesday?
Yep.
We have two more days here. We have to do all Roger's stuff and all the rest of Travis's drums.
Okay.
And there's no way that we're gonna get all that done in 2 days.
We're trying to finish up the record. We have these shows booked. And to have a record out by a certain point, we need to finish it by a certain point.
Well, we got the Cure song, and Travis wants to do two more songs from scratch.
Yeah, right, I don't see that happen. Are you serious?
See where all these like red lines are?
That's when we're gone.
That's when we're gone. So we're right here now. So obviously we're up here, then we go to Pittsburgh for those 2 days, we come back and we leave for Japan on that day.
We have four more songs we're doing.
I know. Is that gonna be, are we gonna be able to do that?
It's really down to you guys finishing lyrics and then do vocals. Which you two seem to be dragging your feet on.
So, I think if we don't do the two songs, we just do the Cure song, and then we do all the other overdubs and singing,
right,
there's a chance we could get it done.
That's a chance.
Yeah.
After the break, does Blink-182 have enough time in Los Angeles? I said a good that time. Yeah.
Up ahead on album launch.
We need to finish this album. That's what it comes down to. We need to finish this record.
We had missile warnings in aircraft today that we were flying to Kuwait, you know? I didn't know if I was always gonna come home.
Welcome to the Blink Record. We're here live at the studio.
You know, a bunch of work to do still. We had these shows, and so we didn't know if we were gonna have, like, if show was gonna have to get canceled or if we were gonna have to postpone the album or what.
We are at Burbank Airport getting ready to go to Canada to play a rock show, but we're gonna go rock the Canadians and make them forget about the deadly disease that's taking over their country.
Played a show a year ago. We practiced 3 times. Are you nervous? No, because we're used to not being good.
After, you know, 6-7 months in the studio, it enabled us to kind of be a band again and go over there and play shows and remember why we were doing this.
This is a brand new song that we're playing tonight for the first time in front of anybody, so I hope you don't f*** it up.
Good to go out and play live shows. We've been in the studio for 7 months, and then to be able to go out and play as a band just felt really good, felt like refreshing.
Those are probably the best shows of our life, I think. We were really, we were on top of our game.
It was such a scary trip in the Middle East, and I thought I was gonna die the whole entire time. When you get launched off a carrier, and the carrier's moving, so the plane can have more speed, but if the plane doesn't get off the carrier runs you over. I mean, when you have experiences like that for 5 days straight, it almost like it was a bad dream, it didn't even happen. And when I say bad dream, it was the most amazing experience.
We had missile warnings in aircraft today that we were flying to Kuwait, you know? I didn't know if I was always gonna come home. It sounds weird, you know? I'm sure our soldiers think that every day.
Meeting and playing for the troops that are in the armed forces was the most enlightening and humbling experience I've ever had.
Pressure's definitely on, you know? We need to finish this album. That's what it comes down to. We need to finish this record. And we haven't been doing it lately.
But Jerry wanted to do... Hey, what's the 80s song called? Always?
So basically, we've been meeting quite frequently over the last month, and there's so much stuff going on, and it's really tricky to schedule all this stuff around.
Well, I got a question. Are those dates locked in? We're done? Because here's the issue.
Yeah.
What happens when brand spanking new comes to us? It says we want you guys on the 13th.
It doesn't include this Palace date.
Oh, label meeting. Oh, check it out. Label meeting.
Why do you always rip my
I don't know what this is.
I'm telling you right now.
I'll tell you right now, you got my lyric
book. This is my book. This is my book. Back off. This is why we have problems, you know, why we can't get done on time.
Did you realize the credit sheets that I've been here for the last 3 days trying to get, he just ripped up?
They come in here and rip up everything. They dismantle our meeting. And this is what happens. Rappers don't do this.
At this point, it's really picking up. The whole machine is starting up, and we're trying to finish the record.
I don't want to have to do all the press and all the pictures, but we're going to do it. And so now we're going to start doing press all over the place. But you know what? It's good, though, because we really want to tell people what we're thinking.
We'll do international press where you sit in a hotel or you sit in a studio for 8 or 9 hours a day and you talk to people.
Lately, we've been having really good interviews. I think a lot of people are really interested about the new record and really excited for the change. And they've been asking good questions. In the past, the questions always revolved around, like, say, oh, Tom, you've been so handsome for so long. How does David Hasselhoff compete?
It's cool. You're telling them about what you just created, you know? So I'm not mad at that. I think I love the opportunity.
We wrote, like, our hardest song, like, our most, like, aggressive song on this record. And we probably wrote our slowest, like, darkest song on this record.
Okay, your French interview is ready whenever you are.
Okay. I am ready right now. There she is.
Okay. What is the best item you've ever splurged on?
Best?
And this
lips! What?
This one, you guys can answer to me instead of the camera.
He splurged on the lips!
After 2 days of press, Tom has reached his breaking point right now. He's talking about erections. That band over there, I'm not in. I'm in this band. Hi.
A lot.
today really kind of is the last day in the studio. Oh yeah, a little nervous maybe. Maybe a little nervous to know that we have to send our little boys off to school to say, hey, hope we raised you right. Hope that you're a good little person. Hope you can deal with all the problems that are out there in the world. That's what it's like sending your songs off.
I will be so happy to have the record finished and be coming out, but at the same time, we have to come up with the enhanced CD-ROM, finish the artwork, pick the single, and shoot the video, and that's all in the next 2 weeks.
It's a pain in the ass, like, you know what I mean? But at the end, like, the finished package, like, we're gonna be so stoked.
People, I work really, really hard for you. You're gonna love it. You guys are doing great, just keep listening.
Coming up on Album Launch. We've all been big fans of David LaChapelle. Everything he ever does is really sexy and really horny.
I'm gonna have a baby tomorrow and I'll talk to you guys in 2 days.
Say hello, everybody. So my name is Landon.
Here today with Scandalous, shooting the videos for the enhanced CD. Scandalous is a photographer and he does videos, and Travis brought him in.
I just started like throwing at him, you know, one after the other, like do this, take photos for this, do our CD cover, do our CD enhancement.
With the enhanced CD, it's like 20 something minutes of video footage put to the music.
We looked at our whole record as a giant art project. I mean, we wanted there to be imagery, like artistic imagery, to go along with the music.
Come on, you guys, sit down. We're gonna sing to you.
There's a couple things that happen in our band. I mean, when we first had our first amount of success, things kind of spun out of control and we didn't have control of anything and people would run with stuff. We would show up places and see how we're portrayed and it wasn't the way we wanted to be, you know, but we didn't have control over it.
I think that on this record, we've really wanted to keep everything very close to us because this record is so personal to all three of us that we really wanted to be involved with every single aspect of it, from the enhanced CD stuff to the songs to the photographs that we have. Everything about our band now, I just feel, is really legitimately us.
I love the look of this picture. I think you look cool in it.
It's cool and it's our band and it represents what we're about and how we want to portrayed to everybody, you know?
It's a totally big deal because it's the back of our record that's going to be there for the rest of your life.
I think no matter what photo you showed me for the back of the record, that was a big photo, I'll be sitting here like this with it. America, is this picture good? Should we do it? Is that the one?
We're going up to the rooftop to shoot the video for Feeling This. It's our first setup of the day.
When we first started talking about the video, David LaChapelle was our first choice. He was someone that, as an artist, has this incredible vision for things.
We wanted the video to be a little mini art project as well. We wanted it to look different. We wanted it to feel different. Everything he ever does is really sexy and really, really horny.
Kids are going crazy. They're naked, like half naked. They have like tattoo symbols on them. It's pretty amazing. Gotta regret it right now. I'm feeling it. The air is
so cold. As far as like a first introduction to this, I think that Feeling This is the song that kind of shows the direction that we're going in now.
But it's like, we need a good hour-long video to show the kids what this record's all about.
We are in Los Angeles listening to mixes.
There's songs getting mixed around the country.
Mark and Tomer in San Diego listening to mixes.
And the way that we've been getting it is through an ISDN line.
What is it called, Alan?
It comes out of their board and everyone can hear it in the studios. Studios in Los Angeles, studio in San Diego.
There you go. And that's what we're doing right now.
The wonders of the internet, you know, it's not just for pornography. You can actually do productive stuff on it.
Hi, how are you?
Hi. Who's over there today?
Here in San Diego is Mark and Tom.
Dynamic duo.
And do we have another connection today, or is it just us?
Yeah, we should have another connection with Chalice in L.A.
Gary? Travis?
Yeah, we're right here.
Can we hear back one more time, just real quick? Sorry.
The end bit.
Yep. Yeah.
I think the song sounds fantastic, by the way, but I just want to hear more attack from the drums, you know what I mean?
Okay.
That'd be badass for me.
I think the morning on the 8th, October 8th, we were still, like, listening to mixes.
Easy Target, we recorded the drums really weird. I don't know if you looked at it yet. It's supposed to sound really industrial. There's, like, a ribbon crasher. I don't know. I'm sure I'll hear it the following day.
Okay.
So, I'm going to have a baby tomorrow, and I'll talk to you guys in 2 days.
The 9th came around. I kind of left my house that morning at, like, 5 in the morning. I had a baby at like 8:19 a.m.
This is my son, Landon, that's my girlfriend. And today's the 10th and it feels like I had him a year ago already. Awesome. And I've completely forgot about our record.
Man, I've never been a father before. I'm still a kid, you know? She's still a kid too, that's what's crazy.
That's gonna be one of the first things he wears when he's this big.
I feel way different now that I'm a dad. The minute you have that baby, like, I don't know. I was so careless. I didn't care about anything. And now I drive better, and I don't know. I think about everything like 100 times before I do it, you know?
Say hello, everybody. So my name is Landon. Landon.
When a record gets mixed, it's the final phase of the recording procedure, and we had literally hours to turn this thing in to have it come out on time, and it was crazy stressful. It was not rad to have that happen after you spend a very long time making a record where time wasn't part of a factor. I mean, we took our time, and when it came down to the last stretch, it just ended up to be the polar opposite of that, and it was just like, run for your life and get this record to the to the factory.
I don't think that there's time to even mix another song tomorrow.
It's gotta be done today. There's no way they're gonna get it.
Tomorrow's
day.
Thursday. We have to, the thing has to be totally done tomorrow to ship to the plant on Friday. The
original due date got pushed back, and then it got pushed back and got pushed back again to the point where it came down to Jordan, the president of the label, making calls and saying, what is the absolute last possible second that we can turn this thing in and still make our release date? I mean, we turn it in at the very, very deadline. Even past the deadline.
It's the last mix of the record, and I think tonight our work will be done, and it will be in the hands of people that are smarter and more talented than us.
The day before the record got turned in, I think we listened to a final mix from somebody else, a feeling this besides Jerry Finn's, and then we ended up picking Jerry Finn's, and I think that was the official like finish of the record, like the wrap.
The question is, are we done? We don't know if we're done. Mark, are we done?
It's never done. That's the answer. It's never done. It's an ongoing process.
You know what half the record is us performing it. When we're done performing it, then it will be done, like, completely. Stop asking so many questions.
Is it done? It's only started.
Coming up next on Album Launch.
We're going to go buy our record. You got to do it. You got to support yourself.
How's it going? I'm John Norris with an MTV News Brief, where you might want to call them Buck 182, because come November, $1 is all it will cost to catch Blink 182 on a rare club tour.
We are gearing up to trek across the United States and do a bunch of shows that cost a dollar, which are conveniently overpriced for one of our shows.
And we didn't really want anyone to sponsor the tour, so we decided to pay for it ourselves.
Wow!
Today we're rehearsing for the Dollar Bill tour.
We did spend a lot of days for rehearsal for this tour, too.
You guys having a good time tonight?
Two big, long, crazy days. And actually the first day was cut short because we figured that we'd get back to it the second day. But we'll be, you know, I think the tour is like 2 weeks long, and we'll be like kick ass by the end of week two.
We were in Boston at our first show in the Dollar Bill Tour.
We have like literally 2 weeks and our record comes out, and we're playing like half of the songs on the record live every night. So obviously it's getting closer to the day our record comes out, so everything's more exciting.
I am excited about tonight. I'm very excited to go out and play these new songs, but you never know until you actually walk out on stage if you're gonna up or if you're gonna be all right or what's gonna happen.
I think that we forgot our teleprompters though, so let's hope that I don't forget the lyrics.
What'll happen if you do?
I make shit up. I call it art.
Hello, Boston! This tonight here is the very, very first time we ever played this song live. Hey, if we fuck up tonight, I'll give you your dollar back.
The song's gonna get you pregnant. Who's it?
These shows are going to be different than those shows we just played over in the festivals and in Europe and stuff. The whole atmosphere is different. We're not going to have any explosions and flaming signs and things of that nature. Now you're just going to have to hear the music.
Tonight's show is a lot of fun. It was a little rusty in some parts. Let's say B minus, C plus kind of show.
I think we can be a lot better, and we will be.
I think the set was rad. I just think we have to move quickly.
Yeah.
Because if you grab them by the balls, and then we kind of like, we grab them and then we let them down, and then we grab them. You know what I mean?
Yeah, keep them. Totally.
Two more shows, it'll be golden.
Hey, we're in New York at Irving Plaza on the Dollar Bill Tour, and we just got done sound checking, and we are bullshitting with our friends and getting ready for the show.
First time we ever played in New York was at this venue. We played with an old punk rock band called Fear, and that's what we felt the whole entire time. There's skinheads out in the audience that didn't like songs about dicks. But we are here, different songs this time.
We're going?
Let's do this.
No! I'm gonna stay here. It's you and me now. You're not invited. I gotta go.
That was crazy,
oh,
huh?
That was terrible.
I was like, oh, it was amazing, man. I love the pressure of New York shows because it makes you play better.
Guys, yeah, that was really good.
Did
really
you like my jazz? I'll stay up.
That was so good.
What? It's a vibrant! Yes! Yes!
Where did that come from?
Oh, that's cool! This is here.
That was our end of recording party right there. That was it. That was the one.
So today we're at New York MTV, and we are about to perform live on the rooftop of MTV. We get to drive in a 59 Cadillac convertible, which is amazing. I've never even driven a car in New York before.
You guys, MTV and Blink-182 bringing at ya spanking new music with...
Yeah, man, it's weird, you know what I mean? You can't hear anybody. It's just like kids crawling at you. It's funny. It's cool, though.
Do I get this for free? This is the exact same size of the top of a chair that I usually sit on at home. The chair's like this. And you sit on there, and it gives you the ability to spin around in several directions as you might be on the internet, watching TV, cooking, whatever, what have you. What have I not? I don't know.
Yeah, it was fun. fun, man. That was a good time. I think we played good too. We usually get really freaked out when we play MTV, but I think it was like good energy with those kids up there, you know?
I'd say it was awesome.
I think, well, you see, our dollar shows, I think we pretty much played worth a dollar. This one was free. I think it was pretty much worth free. We are on our way to put out a record, like on the 18th. I'm not sure really when. It's Tuesday, I don't know. We're on our way back to LA. What are you asking? Who are you? I'm just kidding.
I don't really have any apprehensions about the CD coming out. I'm anxious for it to come out. I'm excited for people to hear the new songs.
I'm not in fear of what anyone's going to think. I think everyone's going to love it. And I don't know. I have no fears.
It's such a long project, you know? And the only anticipation I have is when you bring it up and make me nervous. I don't know what's going to happen when the record comes out. I'm not thinking about it. But when this guy over here asks me, it makes me nervous.
It is 11:15 on the 17th of November, and our record comes out in nearly an hour.
We are K-Rock, Los Angeles. Morning show, Kevin Bean. Millions and millions of listeners. We will be debuting our record on the day it comes out, which is today. Just so happens to be today.
Now's the test. Everyone has a record. We'll see what they say. You know what I mean? Yeah, I want to go buy a copy. Right? How weird is it? This is my first time seeing it. My old lady keeps passing by and saying it's so rad. We're going to go buy our record. You got to do it. You got to support yourself. Beginning, like I think all our goals, I think we accomplished them all. I really feel like proud of it. It feels good. It feels like when you just have your baby and you want to show everyone your baby, like that's what a new record feels like.
Pushing each other into these new directions, I think, has been really an education. So I don't know where the next record will take us, but I'm excited to find out. That's a good ending. I should have held for another beat though.
I think there's only one place we can go, and I think that's all the way. I think we're going to start distributing our music throughout space.